Hey, what's up, you guys? It's me, Naruto Rasengan D. And in this first impressions video, we go over an anime that is kind of a big thing. It was a big thing a couple months ago. It didn't come out that long ago, and I just wanted to give my first impressions on it because I just started it, and, well, let's just say I could finish it fairly quickly, but let me just do a first impressions before I get any further in this anime. The anime in question is Black Rock Shooter. I see things all over the place that are tied in with Blue Exorcist because they're people have like blue eyes and blue flames. I don't know. I saw that at first on Tumblr, Facebook, different places, and I kept seeing Black Rock Shooter all over the place. So I just said, hey, let me just see what it's about. I saw it was 8 episodes, so I thought to myself, why not just check it out? It's really short, simple, easily able to be checked out, and I will be able to do a first impressions on it now because I have gotten started on it. Honestly, before I started watching it, I had very, very high hopes for the anime, and I don't know yet if those hopes are gone or whatever, but I'll get to that later. Let's start off with the plot of the anime right here. So the anime starts off with a girl named Mato, and honestly, it didn't even look like the anime that I was going to watch when I started watching it. It was about this girl, and she was in junior high school. It didn't look anything like Black Rock Shooter from the pictures that I've seen, and it looked really weird at first. I was confused. I was thinking, like, what am I watching? Because what I've seen is, like, this completely different girl, because she had longer hair, and she looked a little bit more pale of skin, and she had different clothing, and I don't know. It just looked completely different than what I saw before. So this is a girl named Mato, and she meets a new girl in junior high school, and, well, this girl has a little bit of emotional problems, some family problems. So we go into some things about her sister and how she has to take care of her and how there is just some issues of her not being able to be free like Mato wanted her to be. The girl's name, I think, is Yomi. And her sister Kagari is being a really needy bitch. And honestly, she's just not getting on Mato's good side, making her cry, you know, emotional problems and stuff like that. It looks like this anime, at first, is not anything close to what I thought it was going to be. But in the first episode, you guys would be very confused. I came into this thinking it was going to be about that girl that I keep seeing, and it kind of is, but it's not at the same time. See, the thing about the anime is it's set in two different worlds, but it goes on one single plot line. It's really confusing at first, but after you get past the second episode, you should kinda get it, and if you don't get it, the third episode might help, and after that, I don't know, because I haven't seen that far yet. But yeah, this storyline is a little bit confusing on the first episode. Honestly, I had no idea what I was watching the first episode, and by the end of the second episode, I kinda got the idea of it, and the third episode kinda threw me off a little bit, and I kinda lost it again. But how this works is everything that happens in Mato's life, she pretty much dreams about this, and it also happens with a representation of herself in this different world. And this world, this is pretty much a world that she made up herself because of a book that she and Yomi have. And this book is about this tiny blue bird who wanted to fly in the blue sky, and the sea reflected the sky, and then it became a sea of the sky, and then there were the tears of the sky, and then the blue bird wanted to fly in the I think I'm going in the right direction here. Not really sure, though. It's kind of confusing. Yes, this anime is a little bit confusing. It can throw a lot of you off. I can see a little bit of symbolism. It kind of helps me out. But if you guys aren't really good with that, it might throw you off completely. But basically, everything that happens in this real world, Mato's world, happens also in her dreams, but it's a lot more action-packed and just crazy, just fucked up. It's like your imagination. It's like her imagination just going wild with all of these things, and it's just, oh my god, you have to see it to believe it. It's just really weird. Not only that, Some of the animation in this dream world is kind of like the animation used for Hatsune Miku. If you guys know Hatsune Miku, the Japanese singer, it's not really a singer because she's not real, but if you guys have seen those types of music videos and you understand the art style that goes into that, it's like 3D animation that they use sometimes in the dream world, and along with that, there's Hatsune Miku music for the opening of the anime. So for a while, what I thought about this anime was that it was really about girls and their emotional problems and how one girl sees it in her dreams. And yeah, that's pretty much a way to describe this anime so far. I'm sorry guys, as a first impression, this can't be very much described. This anime is really short. If I were to watch any more, I'd probably give away too much of the anime, and I don't want to spoil anything for you guys. And, well, it's a short anime, so it has to all be explained within those 8 episodes, and damn, like, I hope it does it well. So in terms of recommendations, would I recommend this to any of you guys? Of course I would, you know? Just, if you guys had time to watch an 8-episode anime, and if you don't, I don't know why not, because some of you guys watch these 100-and-so episode anime, and you have some time to just sit your ass down 4 hours and watch this. It's not that long. It's not exactly boring. It's just very confusing at first. If you guys finish it, you'll probably go back and be like, oh, that makes so much more sense. So besides the plot being a little bit confusing at first, and trust me, if you guys want to check out this anime, you gotta watch at least 2 episodes. You have to at least watch the first 2 episodes. If you watch the first one, you will be just confused as fuck. The first one doesn't explain anything. The second one goes a little bit deeper into explaining shit, and you get it after a while, but the first one, you won't understand what the fuck is going on. So yeah, I would totally recommend for any of you to just go and watch it. Hell, go and watch it right now. Who knows? You might like it. It's really interesting. The dream world, like, the battles that they have are really just crazy. I don't think anybody could really die. The main character can die there so far. It doesn't seem as if she has any vulnerability in her own dream world, which is really kind of awesome, and it makes it so badass. It's just some of the things that you see in that dream world just make you want to go fuck shit up. So I would say that I am very glad I checked out this anime because it is very interesting. It's so confusing, but still interesting. And I cannot wait to finish it in the next 5 episodes, which is going to be really short. But hey, you know, whatever. It's just something to watch. So do you guys have any anime suggestions for me? Just tell me in the comment section below. And let me know if you guys want me to check out any anime and tell me your feedback on these first impression videos. No, but seriously, tell me your feedback because I don't even know. Are these videos good? So for now, it's me, Naruto Rasengan D, saying stay gold. And I will see you guys later. You know you guys should subscribe, right? Subscribing is the only way you can get my videos on time. And it also helps you get the updates and information whenever you need it. So click that button up there and don't forget to thumbs up and comment on this video. Come on, subscribe, you know you want to. Oh.